The other day, I showed up at Monty's Trattoria and found my father, Chef Pietro, slashing a pumpkin in half. I had no idea why and what for. He continued to clean his pumpkin. He then threw some olive oil and butter into a pot, added some bay leaves, chopped some onions, added a bit of minced garlic to the pot, stirred, and wouldn't tell me what he was up to. And then I saw the rice, and Chef Pietro explained it wasn't his favorite rice, Arborio, but he was gonna make do with what he had. He added some stock and the saffron came out, and I knew we were making risotto. But what was up with this pumpkin? Chef Pietro continued to slice it. He then chopped it up, added the pumpkin to his pot, added some stock, some shrimp, some peas, and even managed to sneak in scallops behind my back. He stirred his risotto, allowed it to simmer, and then started scooping it into the pumpkin. But why? I still had no idea who this dish was for. After all, it's not on our menu. He then ran up the stairs and I realized he was asked to cook for a party. Chef Pietro was asked to design his own menu.
So it's better to let the chef make the menu, right? Instead of ordering.
It's true.
Always,
you're right. When a chef gets to make the menu, that's where the magic comes. You guys enjoy. Bon appetito.
Oh, so
thank
you.
Oh, Pietro grande. Oh, mamma mia, guarda questi.
Beautiful.
Pietro, grazie mille. Evviva, grande Pietro, grazie.
He made this with heart pounding, very excited.
We know, as usual.
See, the Italians always dress so nice.
Salute.
Salute.
Salute, ragazzi, evviva.
Calamari in that, look at that.
Calamari looks so
I wish I wasn't allergic. So